政府正在检讨慈怀护理的津贴框架，以利急速老化的人口能拥有有质量、有尊严的临终护理。当局也将为专业慈怀护理服务领域培训更多专业人员，并为看护者提供更多支持。
两位国会议员黄玲玲和叶汉荣联合在国会提出休会动议，呼吁政府加强对慈怀护理的支持，让更多年长人士实现在家中离世的心愿。
Early delivery of palliative care reduce unnecessary hospital admissions and the use of health services, thus managing healthcare costs increases. We need to step up awareness and access to palliative care options in the coming years.
Many just don't know what to do. This is unfortunate, but hardly surprising. Death is an uncomfortable subject. But as they say, you can fall ill many times, but you only die once.But when it comes to our twilight years, many people refuse to face up to the inevitable.
卫生部高级政务次长拉哈尤马赞回应时表示，慈怀护理将进入更多社区医院，而家庭医生也将发挥他们的作用。当局已同综合护理机构和服务商展开合作，为更多专业人士提供培训。
Beyond specialized services, we also want to entrench palliative care as a basic skill set for all healthcare professionals across disciplines and settings. This will require us to change the mindsets and instincts of our clinicians and equip them with the necessary skills and tools. We agree that in the longer term, family doctors can play a role, building on relationships forged with their enrolled residents.
当局还将加强公众教育，让国人进一步接受和正视临终与死亡的话题。